St. Elmo Brady was born in Louisville, Kentucky, December 22, 1884. He went to Tuskegee Institute, which is now Tuskegee University. There he taught, and while he was teaching there, he was awarded a scholarship to the University of Illinois. He continued on to do a PhD in chemistry, and he completed that in 1916. That made him the first African-American to receive a PhD in chemistry in the United States.
He had a quote when he was first studying at the University of Illinois. He said that when he entered the program to get his doctorate, that there were 20 whites and one other in the class, himself being the one other. And that when he finished, there were 6 whites and one other. And he felt that students could get inspiration from that. Everything is not going to be easy, no matter how smart you are, but that you can do it.
Once he left the University of Illinois, he went back to Tuskegee. He then left to Washington, D.C. to teach at Howard University. He built the chemistry program, and he started fundraising to build a state-of-the-art building.
He wanted to give back to his people, and he did. But he had to make the decision between earning more money and not having a Bunsen burner, barely a Bunsen burner, when he went back to Tuskegee. And my grandmother, she was okay with the decision, but I think she might have been happier he'd have made another choice, because she, after they left Tuskegee, she wouldn't move back to the South. They called each other my dear sweethearty whenever they were writing to each other. All their cards and all were signed like that. It was a good relationship. And some people could do that with absence. And they did. They managed it.
After he was at Howard University, he went to Fisk University. And he taught at Fisk University for 25 years. And then he retired. He came out of retirement and he went to Tougaloo College in Mississippi.
St. Elmo Brady came to Tougaloo as one of the last schools that he worked up, and we have a plaque out in the chemistry lab that dedicated the laboratories to him. He really established the chemistry program, and the chemistry program has been a strong program ever since. One of the most important aspects of this, to my opinion, is to give black students an opportunity to view a chemist from many others who have done great things in chemistry. And these hopefully will encourage them to go on and do some great things themselves.
For Fisk, it's for students really understanding that his name is not just a name on a building, but he had a great impact in terms of what we have to offer to them. In the 25 years he was there, he actually started the undergraduate, and he had the first black or graduate program at HBCU. We have a lot of partnerships in terms of students going and doing undergraduate research in the summertime. So I know one of his big things was the FTIR, Fourier Transform Infrared Spectroscopy. He actually came and brought students, undergraduate students, and also some of the professors from FIS to come here to learn about the FTIR and how you can actually apply it to chemical structures. Now with him being honored and really all of this other information coming out, it opens a lot of people's eyes in terms of the contributions that minorities have placed in history.
I find him important because as an African American that actually attended this university as an undergrad and a grad student, I think it's important to know that I belong here.
I want the world to know about him and to have him live on, to be able to educate other students. As that was, even though he'd grumble about not doing enough research, he loved educating.
Growing up in my generation, there were few African-American role models in science. And pioneers like St. Elmo Brady broke that new ground. They showed the world that the color of your skin didn't prevent you from being a chemist or a college professor or even the chancellor of one of the original land-grant universities. St. Elmo Brady utilized his education to go out and change the world. And that's the epitome of what we try to provide every student here at the University of Illinois.